five of you, right here, raise your hand. The graduating cherubs get to have their own part. So you get to see them show off their set as our graduates. Thank you. All right, you guys ready? Find your smile. Ready? Okay.
Thank you, cherubs. Parents, if you'll stand so they can find you. That was wonderful, cherubs. And congratulations to those of you who will be graduating from the Cherubs to Kids Praise. What a delight. Oh, it's so fun to see all these characters ready. I recognize who you are. People kept coming up to me, the kids kept coming up to say, so what am I? And frequently the ears or the tail gave it away. But your sleeves give it away. Yes, yes, I recognize, I think that's snow? Is it snow? No. Is that snow? That's snow, okay. I know snow. I know what Snow White looks like. Well, welcome, everyone. My name is Janet Forbes. I'm one of the ministers here at St. Luke's. And welcome to the Children's Dinner Theater production. The production of Into the Woods. But I did mention dinner. Wasn't it fabulous? Oh, let's thank our dinner preparers and servers. I tell you, I love to come. I thought either it's going to be those great chicken tenders or mac and cheese, and it was sliders and mac and cheese. Ah, I absolutely love that. So thank you very much to those of you who cooked and served. It was a delicious dinner for all of us tonight. Well, you're going to experience a fairy tale, a mixture of fairy tales, full of suspense and adventure and humor. And I understand some great sound effects from our media team back there. Yes, oh, they're all ready. Okay. At St. Luke's, all of our drama productions always serve the greater good. And tonight, the children offer their gifts and talents for the benefit of Love in the Name of Christ, Love, Inc. And I want to invite a member of the board of directors of Love, Inc. to come and share just a little bit about the ministry of Love, Inc. with you. Glenn Gravel. Glenn is a member of Littleton United Methodist Church and tells me he's brand new to the board of Love, Inc. Glenn, welcome.
Thank you. Hello, hello. Can you hear me? Doug McKinney, our executive director, is at a workshop down in Albuquerque, so he could not be here tonight and asked if I could come, and I'm very happy to be here. It's such a joy to be around the kids. Last Thursday, we were in Austin, Texas, where our six-year-old was in the play musical called The Jungle, and it was really lively, and we very much enjoyed that. Tonight, you're making a contribution to Love, Inc. to help with all the GAP ministry that we want to provide. GAP ministry means that we help churches to coordinate with other churches and to meet the needs of the needy in the area. And that's why I joined the Love, Inc. board. I'm on church and society for our church, have been for 15, 20 years. And there's always a lot to do, as you know. Tonight's donations go to the grocery gift card program, the severe weather lodging program, and the personal care items also that you're contributing will go to Love, Inc. to needy families. So all this is very much appreciated. If you've not already visited, I want to draw your attention to the thrift store, and it's called Renewed Treasures, north of Arapahoe Road on the east side of Broadway. And it's a place where you can bring things that are in good service, that they can be utilized by people. And people who are recipients of the services go over there on a discount and can shop there. So everybody benefits. And if you've been over there or want to volunteer, they need people to do the various jobs that are involved there. So I appreciate and a great deal of thanks to all of you. And on with the show.
Thank you, Glenn, very much. And thanks to all of you for the support of Love in the Name of Christ. You know, of course, that every year the United Methodist Church has a theme for family ministry, and our children's dinner theater always follows the theme for the year, and this year it's love. And so we're grateful for the ministry of Love in the Name of Christ and for your participation. Let me remind you, it will be a full summer for children's ministries. Go to the website and you'll be able to see the offerings and sign up for those. Particularly, I want to remind you that on May 17th is movie night, and everybody comes in their jammies with their sleeping bags, and we have popcorn, and it's Wreck-It Ralph. So, May 17th. And then this summer, we still have openings at Evening Vacation Bible School in July and every Wednesday for Wacky Wednesday. So I invite you to the website. Let's see. The last thing I wanted to tell you is, parents, after the show, you can meet your children in the lobby right out there. They'll be waiting for you, and you can congratulate them and then take them downstairs to change and get their makeup off and so forth. So you can meet them in the lobby. I believe, break a leg, everyone. Isn't that what we say? Break a leg? And on with the show.
Grimm's Woods. Actually, my woods. I'm Horace Grimm. caretaker of this forest. Not much happens here. It stays pretty quiet. But I'm glad when you come to visit. Lots of wonderful things happen here when you are looking in. I think you must provide the special magic that brings things to life among the trees. When you peek in on these woods, strange things happen. The woods bring forth tales of love, heartbreak, adventure, thrills, scares, and surprises. Oh, I think I hear something stirring. Looks like your arrival has caused some magic to bubble up. Let's see who's there.
My, where did you come from? I didn't realize you were there. My mother used to say, Goldilocks. She called me that because, well, you know, the hair. Goldilocks, it's not polite for you to eat in front of others if you had enough to share. I'd offer you some, but there are, well, several of you. And if we had to split it all up, you can imagine how crummy that would be. Crummy, get it? Crumbs, that's all we get, huh? Well, anyhow, I do hope you're not too hungry. Food isn't easy to come by in these woods. In fact, trying to keep from starving and feeding my two younger sisters can be a full-time job. Come on out, guys, these folks are harmless. I call them the Goldie Socks twins. They're quite a mixed matched pair. Seems everyone is searching for something around these parts, but it's not all gloomy, you understand? Out here, just when life is the worst you can get, things begin to look up. Only a few days ago, we were getting pretty desperate until I stumbled upon that cottage up the road. I'll tell you the story if you have a minute. You do have time, don't you?
It's rather an unusual story.
But that's not surprising in these woods.
You have heard about Grimm's Woods, right?
No? Well, let me tell you. Once upon a... Once there was a...
You should get comfortable. She can get pretty worried.
Well... Long, long ago, there lived a... Wait, I know. Close your eyes. Imagine stumbling upon the strangest little cottage with the strangest little family of bears living there.
Yes, she said bears.
I know it sounds impossible. Bears living in a cottage the same way humans do.
Surprisingly, good porridge cooks.
But as I said before, nothing is surprising in Grimm's Woods.
More wolf signs in the wood near the village. What a bunch of wackos. Still telling those old wives' tales about the big bad wolf.
Now, Harry, some of those reports came from some very reliable folks. In fact, Julia Horner was saying that her dog chased away a wolf right out of her kitchen window.
Yeah, a wolf named Jack Horner. I caught him sticking his thumb right into the middle of a pie over at the baker's shop in the village. Little weasel. Hiding in the corner thinking nobody would see him. Kid needs a haircut and a job. Besides, those humans get worked up over anything. And it's no wonder. They sit around telling stories about wicked stepmothers and witches.
My friend Mason told me they had a terrible time with a wolf. He threatened to huff and puff
and blow the house down. Nonsense. Talking wolves, what's next? Dancing frogs? Say, what you making?
I'm hungry as a bear? Deer. Hungry as a bear?
Yeah, I suppose so.
Who made that one up anyway? Those humans must think all we do is eat and hibernate. Well, never mind the humans, dear. I'm fixing your favorite porridge with just a touch of butter and honey. I thought, while it cooled, we could go gather some fresh berries for dinner tonight. There are some beautiful blackberries down at Elder Creek the Blue Jays haven't discovered yet.
Do I have to go? I'm putting the gumdrops on the witch's gingerbread house, and I don't want the frosting to dry out.
Good heavens, Baby Bear. Why on earth are you making a replica of the old witch's candy house?
Well, you said to never go near the witch's house, no matter how yummy it looked. So, I made my own from gingerbread.
As long as you stay far away from the real one. Those old witches can't be trusted. And while we're on the subject of being eaten, are you planning on helping us eat your mother's blackberry cobbler tonight?
I had planned on it.
Then you better plan on helping us gather the berries. You know, you haven't been out much lately. If I didn't know any better, I think you'd be going into early hibernation. You need to get outside, play with your friends, chase some campers, or, you know, climb some trees.
I too have noticed you haven't played outside much lately. Used to be you were always out fishing with the pond at your friends. Those Wolfdales aren't getting to you, are they?
No, it's nothing like that.
Then what, Baby Bear? If there's a problem, perhaps your father and I can help.
I still like going fishing and all, but it seems that, well, it seems...
Seems what?
Seems that every time we leave our cabin, weird stuff happens.
Weird stuff, dear?
What do you mean by weird?
Things disappear into thin air.
Disappear?
Listen, I know it sounds crazy, but I can prove it. Remember last week and when we decided to visit Uncle Teddy? Mama had made some bread rolls, and we each had two, right?
Yes, two, with butter and jelly.
Well, I left one of mine because I thought I'd have it when we returned.
Yes, I remember you saying that. You'd have your last bread roll when we got back.
Well, when we got back, there was no sign of it anywhere! I think we have a thief that waits for us to leave and steals our things while we're away.
Now, wait a minute. Don't you think that's jumping to conclusions?
Why, yes, dear. It could have been a mouse, or perhaps a bird flew in the window and found it there.
But we know the birds and the mice, and they always ask before they take anything.
True.
That's not the first time either. I just have this feeling that someone is watching us.
Now, look at us. We're getting all worked up just like those silly humans. Let's get down to Elder Creek and pick those berries.
But don't you think...
What if?
Ah, nonsense. We live in the safest neck of the wood. We're far enough from the old witch's house, and the nearest human is half a mile away.
You're right, Papa. It's probably just these tales everyone's spreading.
But I...
No more tales. Let's get going. All right. Come along, everyone. Let's get those berries.
Where have we seen this cottage? I wonder if they've gone this time.
I'm so tired and hungry. This chair is made for a giant. Too cold.
I'll try this one. Just right. Just like Mother used to make. Oh, am I tired. Now, which bed did I like best?
Hmm.
Boulder Creek absolutely beautiful today? That was the most pleasant walk we've had in a while.
Nothing like fresh air to clear the lungs, and who'd have thought we'd come home with a bonus? Here, baby bear, let me take a look at that.
My goodness, yes. Papa Bear, would you like the candle on the table, please?
Sure, dear.
See, it's gone, isn't it? I told you so. Hey, look, it's missing. You saw me, it's missing the gumdrops. You saw me put them on.
And someone's been eating your porridge.
It's all gone!
Something fishy is going on around here.
I told you weird things kept happening, but you didn't believe me. You thought I was just...
I hear something.
How long have we been asleep? We better get going before the bears return.
Well, looks like things are stirring now. Let's head towards the edge of the forest into a road in the woods. Looks like we've added a few more characters into our story. Let's listen in.
Are you sure these beans are magical? I mean, I did give you our cow for them.
Yes, my son. Why? Yes, my son. They are magical. Why do you doubt us?
It's not you exactly. It's my mother. She thinks I act too quickly, says I'm impulsive. I've been in a lot of tight spots lately. Maybe she's right. I don't think first.
Believe me, these magical beans will get you out of all the tight spots you have found yourself in. And your mother will be so happy when she is a rich woman.
There, good luck.
Jack? Jack Horner? Is that you?
Uh-oh, these beans better work fast.
You lousy
cheater, pumpkin eater,
pumpkin, huh? You lousy little.
There. What has the boy done that's so terrible?
I sent him up the hill with my daughter Jill here to fetch a lousy pail of water. That's all. Water to make some soup. Is that so much to ask?
Certainly not.
Now I realize my daughter can be a little competitive and all.
And she loves to win, but that no good.
Cheater
decides to race up the hill.
But they are children, and children play these games, yes?
Yes, it was a game, that's all.
I would have won if you hadn't tripped me.
My daughter always wins.
You tripped over your own 2 feet. Perhaps she is how do you say it?
A klutz?
I am no klutz. He fell down.
I nearly broke my crown.
And my poor Jill, she came tumbling after.
But why did she fall?
Klutz.
Why you.
Don't forget to use your magic beans, Jack.
Magic beans? What a knucklehead.
Here, Bessie, come along, little moo cow.
Thank you.
poor Jack always seems to be getting into trouble. I think he means well, and maybe those magic beans will help him out later. For now, I want to check in and see how Goldilocks and her sisters are doing, trying to get away from that bear family. They could use a friend, or two, or three.
Something from me? How was I supposed to know you weren't some frightening creature skulking about, waiting to pounce and eat me? Did I say that out loud? Ooh, why do I say these things? As if there isn't enough to worry about in these woods. You know, you didn't have to try and steal my food. I would have given you something if only you'd asked.
Again, I am very sorry. Those are my little sisters, the Goldilocks twins. Quite a pair.
I saw.
Hungry?
I suppose we haven't had much luck finding generous souls like you.
Well, honestly, it doesn't take much to frighten me. I absolutely dread walking in these woods, especially at this time of night. What was that?
I didn't hear anything.
Probably my own knees knocking together. Did I hear you say your name is Goldilocks? That's a rather peculiar name.
Well, yes and no. My name is actually Golda, but I have this hair and, well, you know how mothers can be.
Why, yes, I had one once. She called me Red Riding Hood. How's that for a silly name? She made me this cloak. My real mother is gone now. I have a stepmother now. These are her sons. I call them the Red Riding Dudes.
Our mother is gone as well.
You keep looking behind you. Are you waiting for someone?
Oh, not exactly. We are running from someone.
Oh, who?
Three bears.
Bears? Three? Oh, great. My stepmother warned me about wolves lurking in this part of the forest, but she never mentioned any bears.
Wolves? Have you seen any wolves in these woods?
Not with my own eyes, but I have a neighbor who swears he saw one prowling around his chicken coop. Stepmother tells me every evening about their big ears and their big glowing eyes. Then she hands me this basket filled with fresh fruit and bread, and sends me in this bright cloak all the way across the forest to Grandmother's house. Say, do you think...
Your stepmother sends you out to Grimm's Woods at dusk? That does seem a little curious. Why not leave in the morning so you can make your trip by the light of day?
She says it's because there are so many chores to be done. Chop the wood, get the pies to the market, milk the cow, churn the butter. Well, you get it. And besides, if I don't make the trip, my grandmother will starve. She's not well. Her eyesight and hearing are very poor these days. I grabbed the boys to come along with me tonight. Are you all right?
Yes, just, well, all this talk of starving and all. We've been so busy running from bears, I forgot I haven't eaten all day except a small bowl of porridge.
You do look a little pale, and goodness, where are your shoes? Have you no cloak either? You'll catch your death of cold. Did I say death? Ew, I wish I hadn't said that word. Here.
Thank you, it's marvelous.
Where do you live?
Here, there, and
anywhere. Nowhere, really.
Have you run away? Where is your family?
All gone. We're all that's left. We've lived on our own in these woods nearly 2 years now.
Home? 2 years? Oh my, you must think I'm ridiculous complaining about a silly little walk in the woods. I must seem quite the coward.
Not at all. Even I don't travel in these woods after dark. Probably why we've never met, if it hadn't been for those bears.
How do you do it? Is it hard living for you? Is it hard for you living out here?
Well, not always. In the winter, we find shelter under a drafty porch or in an abandoned cottage. Usually, we share space with the field mice and spiders. Food is hard to find in the winter for all of us. In the spring and summer, though, I can gather berries down at Wild Elder Creek, sleep under the pines, and listen to the wind rush through the treetops. The stars are spectacular at night. And when I lay on my back and gaze at them for hours, all of the sadness goes away. I'm just glad my sisters and I have finally found someone to play with other than the critters out here.
I am such a coward. The slightest snap of a twig makes my heart pound.
Well, what was that?
Could be anything. Squirrels, birds, or rabbits.
Wolves, could it be wolves? Stepmother told me about their big yellow eyes and their sharp fangs. She said they can hear you breathing from a mile away.
Honestly, I think those are just stories to keep young children in their beds at night. I've not seen any sun's creatures in the time we've been living in the woods. You walk in these woods every night and still you're so terrified?
I know, it must seem silly. In the evening, as the shadows deepen and I'm on my way home, I light my candle and start out walking. It's as though I can hear these woods whisper all around me. I start out walking, but then I feel a cold breeze on the back of my neck. I tell myself it's only the wind, but the next thing I know, my legs are moving faster and faster, my candle is no longer lit, and I am running from, well, of course I wouldn't know because I am too petrified to look back. All I can think about is getting home as fast as I can. When I do get home, it takes me hours to calm myself down. I love my grandmother, but I do not know how much more of this nightly torture I can take.
I see. Wait, you say you go to your grandmother's house every night?
Every night, same time.
Well, I have an idea that could be helpful to the both of us. What if I were to take your basket to your grandmother's house? You did say that she doesn't see or hear well anymore.
She recognizes me only by the red cloak I wear, though she does still like the company. I suppose your plan could work, but I have nothing to give you for such a generous offer.
But you do. Perhaps you can include an extra apple and some fresh bread in the basket? I wouldn't need much, really. I'd be good company for your grandmother. I could look out for her, and you could look after the twins. They seem to really like your stepbrothers. I'm so tired of worrying whether they will get a next meal or whether there's even gonna be one. Will you consider it?
Well, it certainly would solve both of our problems. Yes, I think it's a wonderful idea. We shall meet at this very spot every evening. Here, you must take these if you are to travel this path every night.
But what will you wear?
I have a cobbler friend in the village. I'll trade some fresh cream and eggs for a new pair. Besides, I've nearly outgrown these.
Over here, I think she went this way.
Oh dear! The bears, I can't let them find us.
Bears, oh my, take this. Okay. Oh, yeah. anything to us, ma'am?
Did you see any other humans around here?
No, Mr. Bear.
Have you seen a girl with yellow curls and bare feet pass this way?
And two little sneaks following along?
No, ma'am. I'm the only one here with no shoes upon my feet, as you can see, but my hair is brown. What do you want with these girls?
They are thieves. They crept into our home and stole from us. They must be taught a lesson.
Perhaps they suffer already. What did they steal from you?
Well, a bit of homemade porridge.
With butter and honey.
And they stole a nap on my bed and my gumdrops.
I see. Take this honey as payment for what the girl has taken.
And these cookies for the gumdrops.
I'm afraid I cannot repay the nap, but if I see her, I will tell her that there are better ways to get food and rest.
Why is your friend so quiet?
What better way to learn than to listen?
I suppose we better get home before nightfall.
Humans.
You may not be the bravest girl in all the woods, but you certainly can think on your feet. But that bear's right. I am a thief. When people see me, they shake their heads. I know what they're all thinking. Poor little orphan has to steal her food, steal her sleep, and steal her shelter. That's the worst part about being in these woods.
That is not what I think. I think you've done the best you can to survive out here on your own, and there is a lot of good in you, Golda. And I can tell you love your sisters dearly. After all, it was you who came up with this brilliant idea that will help both of us.
I suppose. Well then, speaking of ideas, I'd better get to your grandmother's house if I'm going to make that delivery.
Okay, simply follow this lane until it comes to a dead end. There's that awful word again. I have got to stop doing that. Anyways, you'll see a small cottage on your right. That's hers. I guess I'll see you tomorrow around dusk?
Tomorrow, same time. Oh, here's your cloak.
Keep it. Remember, grandmother only knows me by the red cloak.
Well then, don't forget these. You may get hungry on your road back.
Here you go, girls. I'm not so hungry anymore.
Thanks, girls. Be good. I'll see you soon.
Goodbye. Bye. Good luck.
Thank you. Who's there? Is someone there?
Looks like Goldilocks did find some friends, and now she has gotten herself into quite the adventure. Bears, wolves, what else are we going to find in this forest? You guys have brought some strong magic with you tonight. Now all we need is a witch or two.
You won't get away, boy.
Catch him.
What do you want with me? What have I done?
Ooh, plenty, plenty.
Yes, I'd say so, plenty.
We have been sent with this degree from the king, with a degree from the king sheriff.
Yes, an important degree, I should say, boy.
We, butcher, baker, and candlestick maker, and our wives have formally taken our complaints in proper authorities.
The proper authorities, indeed.
These include charges against for Jack putting a thumb into my beautiful plum pie.
What? I didn't know such thing.
Are you Jack or are you not?
I am, yes, but...
Of course he is. He's the one who caused
my daughter Jill to tumble.
It was an accident.
And as we were running from the pie piddling scene, you nearly jumped over my candlestick, knocking it over, and nearly burnt down my shop.
Did you not?
But I never stuck my thumb in any pie. There could be lots of Jacks in this village.
Enough.
According to the decree, you are to return with us to be on trial or be banished to Grimm's Woods.
What? For crimes I have not committed?
We have Sheriff Humpty's orders.
The sheriff? I'm to be tried by a giant egg?
Shall we add treasons to the charges?
He's not just an egg.
He's a good egg.
Of course he's an egg. He can do nothing for himself and can only sit upright 2 days out of every year. Why, it was only last month that he fell off the wall yet again.
It was tragic.
And all the king's horses.
And all the king's men.
You must come with us.
Stand back, or I'll throw these magic beans and cast a powerful spell on you.
Magic beans?
Yes, they possess a powerful magic that will turn you all into toads.
Perhaps we should be considered about these magic beans.
I've heard tales of such things.
If we become toads, I will be forced to eat flies.
I hate flies.
Then there is but one solution.
Get him!
I warned you!
Get him again!
It's a witch!
What about the boy?
He's banished anyway, let's go!
Rub-a-dub-dub, three fools in a tub, and who might you think they'd be? The butcher, the baker, yes, yes, and the candlestick maker, fools all three.
What's this, a bean?
Mice, not now, this is not any bean, it is a magic bean. What a treasure this will be for my stew.
Now we've got witches. I get a little nervous when the witches appear in the story. They can be up to pretty scary stuff. But first, who needs a stretch? Everyone stand up and stretch. On the count of three, I need you to say hi-ho. Ready? One, two, three. Hi-ho! It's time to call the seven dwarves. Now go ahead and sit back down, get comfortable, and let's see what happens next. Back to the gingerbread house where the witches live, and maybe, just maybe, the seven dwarves will stop by.
Oh,
Hansel. I miss our home. I wonder what Father is doing right now.
I know, Gretel. I miss it too. But remember, Father is the one who left us in these woods.
I know, but he still is our father, and I love him. Maybe he didn't mean to leave us out here in the woods. Maybe Lucerda, that evil stepmother of ours, forced him into leaving us here.
Perhaps you're right, Gretel, but that doesn't help us now.
How long have we been captured?
50 days.
I'm starting to give up hope. What are we going to do?
I have to stay strong. Now, stay quiet or those witches might hear you. They are probably on their way back now.
And they're mice, too. Being blind has made their hearing extra good.
Hi-ho, hi-ho, it's home from work we go. Hi-ho, 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 it's home from work we go. Hi-ho, hi-ho.
Oh my, look at this adorable little cottage.
It's full of candy.
Probably stale.
Let's eat some.
Achoo! Better not. I might be allergic.
Never fear. I am a doctor.
Oh, can we rest?
Let's get a little closer. Perhaps we should say hello.
I'm always ready to meet new folks, aren't you, Bashful?
Is someone out there?
Help us.
Come on, did you hear that?
Sounds like someone needs help.
I better get my medical bag.
Better rest up.
Achoo! Mouse hair!
Oh, hello. Do you live here?
Why, yes, we do live here.
We thought we heard someone yelling for help.
Help? I'm sure it was.
It was just, it was,
Me three.
Ow, ow, ow.
We can be clumsy.
Oh, yeah.
Quite.
So sorry to bother you. We'll be on our way.
Be careful out in these woods.
Yes, very careful.
Miss Snow White? Yes, Dopey?
Is that a wolf?
Two witches were up to something. Let's check in on Goldilocks again. She's probably almost made it to Grandmother's house by now. Oh, wait, what's this? Looks like something furry's got to Grandmother's house first. Better see what's up.
Allergies.
There, there, I'll get you some mint tea for that. Wait right here. Now what did I do with my glasses? Ah!
Grandmother? Grandmother, I'm here. I brought you some food and tea. I hope you're feeling well.
Hello, dearie.
You're looking, well, are you hungry?
Yeah. Why, yes, as a matter of fact, I am.
I have fresh cheese or biscuits, or perhaps you'd prefer some fruit?
Those are all very lovely, dearie, but I seem to be craving something else.
I'm afraid I haven't much else in my basket.
There are always other choices, my dear. Maybe we should look beyond your basket.
I'm not sure what you mean. Your eyes, they seem unusually luminous, yellow and large tonight.
Better that I might see you in this dim light, dearie.
So your vision is better? And your ears? They do seem too large and a bit fuzzy, if I may say so.
Ah, yes, that I might hear the sweet, familiar sound of your breathing from a mile away, my dear.
A mile? Oh my, that's rather remarkable for a person your age. Your teeth. I have never seen any so pointed and sharp. I suppose they're used for more than just biscuits and tea?
Indeed, my dear. What a bright young girl your mother has raised. Too bad that she never taught you about the wolves in these woods.
Creatures. Away with you! Back to the nightmare from which you came. Bad dog. You're a bad, bad dog.
No, why didn't you get this on?
Oh my goodness.
Are you ladies all right?
I'm fine, but I'm afraid she's rather shaken.
For an elderly woman, such frail condition must have taken all of her strength to find help. It was fortunate that I was in these woods. I'm merely in these parts.
You aren't from these woods? Was it all that talk of tales of wolves that brought you here lately?
If only it were so. My business here devours me more readily than any cowardly wolf.
What does bring you here, if not the wolves?
Loneliness, guilt, sorrow. They bring me to these woods. They're far greater foes than any mere wolf.
Why? You seem so good, noble, and certainly brave.
Your words are kind, but do not waste them on me. For there was a time I was blinded by beauty. I loved a woman who only loved herself. And for that, I have lost my children.
You have children?
Had. Two beautiful children. And that is why I'm in these woods. I am searching for them.
Why did they run away?
They didn't run away. I tricked them. Their own father, they trusted me, but I tricked them. I left them alone, these horrible woods.
I can't believe you'd be capable of such a thing. There must be more to your story.
Our family fell on hard times. There was little food in the house. It was soon. I had no work. And it was soon clear that we would all perish from starvation.
That's a very common story in these woods.
Lucretia, the children's stepmother, suggested that we leave the children in the forest. She said they would have a better chance to survive here. It made perfect sense at the time. While the children slept, I crept away. Not an act of bravery. When I returned, I found Lucretia dying on a bowl of porridge. She had hidden the grain away in order to help herself. Even while all of us starved, she knew that there was that sack of grain there.
Oh, I do love porridge. Oh, sorry. It must have been painful.
Painfully foolish! 2 weeks passed. I could no longer stand the thought of my children alone in these woods. While Lucretia whistled merrily and grew fat on the stores of grain she had hid. So I returned to the place where I left them, and I've been searching for them ever since.
And your wife, has she changed her ways? Does she want her children back?
I don't know. I've heard that fever and illness have taken her in these 9 weeks that I have been away. I do not deserve my children at all.
But you saved our lives. Maybe I can help. I know these woods very well. I survived here without a mother or father. There is still hope that your children are out there. Where did you last see them?
What I would give to see them again. Their names are Hansel and Gretel. We camped near Elder Creek. If they live, I know they will be together. They were inseparable. I will search the woods to the west. If you find them, please send them to the village. I have found work at Old Man's Dressler's store. I work in his, and live in his store. If they come back, we'll never be hungry again.
I will find them, and I will send them back to you.
It looks as though your intruder has gone for now, but lock your doors and shut the windows. And do take care of your grandmother.
I will take care of her, though she's not my grandmother. My name is Goldilocks. I have promised a friend that I would take care of her. You see, I too know the pain of loss and hunger. Thank you for saving my life.
My pleasure. Though, there is one more thing.
Yes?
I understand if the children choose not to join me. After all, I did betray their trust. But please tell them. Tell them that I love them. Good night.
Night.
Little Red Riding Hood, my dears, are you still there?
I'm here, Grandma. I'm here. You were very brave, and you now need some rest. I'll keep watching till morning. Sleep now.
Bless you, Red Riding Hood.
Oh, that poor woodsman. I hope he finds his kids. Sounds like he really loves them and just made a terrible mistake leaving them in the woods. At least he's found some folks to help him out. Sometimes when you hit hard times, that's all you need is a friend to help find your way. Well, a lot is happening in my little woods, and something tells me it's only gonna get busier.
Thank you. sure is a busy night in the woods. Glad I have my house of bricks to protect me.
Look at it, Hayward. You'd think Mason was trying to fend off the king's army with that fortress.
Yeah, the king's army. That's a good one, Stickley.
Go ahead and laugh, Stickley. It wouldn't take more than an army of ants to walk off with your house of sticks.
Ha! An army of ants. Get it, Stickley. That's a good one, Mason.
Stop snorting, Hayward.
Speaking of ants, haven't either of you heard the story of the ants and the grasshopper? The grasshopper scoffed at the hardworking ants as they planned and gathered food for the winter, while the lazy grasshopper sat about doing nothing at all? Seem familiar?
Yeah, I suppose that's all fine and good if you're speaking of mere insects, but we're intelligent beings, ain't we, Hayward?
Smarter than dogs, I say.
Besides, truffles are available all year long.
Good one, Snickley.
Do wolves count as dogs? All you ever think about is food. We're not in the village anymore. These stories of Grimm's Woods are no laughing matter. Hayward, your house of straw won't keep you safe from such a creature.
You didn't say nothing about no wolves, Stickley.
Oh, don't let the old ham bone scare you. Those are just wives' tales. We've lived in these woods for a while now, and I, for one, can say that I had never, ever seen a real live wolf around these parts. Just very hairy grandmas.
Yeah, Mason. Never.
Little pig, let me come in.
Huh?
Not by the hair of my chinny chin chin.
Oh yeah, not by the hair of my chinny chin chin.
Then I shall huff and puff and blow your house in.
Go on. You can't blow this house down. Well, on second thought, well, you certainly wouldn't want to if I'm not even in it.
Over here, Hayward, quickly.
Why don't you make this easy on yourselves? Your house of sticks is no match for my strength. Why, once I blew a house like yours into the next county. Come out, Piggly Wigglies. Maybe we can make a deal.
You're full of hot air, all right. We're not coming out. We know what you're up to. We're smarter than dogs, you know.
Yes, hot dogs, perhaps. Come out, my little bacon bits. Let's make this easy.
No way. We heard the tales.
Oh, all right. If you insist, we'll do it the hard way. Little pigs, let me come in.
Not on the hair of our chinny chin chins.
Then I'll huff and I'll puff and I'll...
Go, dude, go. Go.
I'll get you, you blasted pigs. I've lost my patience with you. Well, you better run and consider yourself evicted.
Max. Jen, come on, I'm coming.
Nice work, Stickly. First, you get us nearly eaten by a wolf, and now it seems your little shortcut has gotten us lost in the woods. Perhaps we should pick up an apple or two and drop in on a luau.
Oh boy, why didn't you just stay home then?
Oh wait, we can't. The wolf lives there now.
Well, I wanna go home.
We have no home.
Wee, wee, wee.
Quiet down, Hayward. We'll find our way to the market. We always do. Let's take another look at our map.
This is Elder Creek, but I don't remember it being so gloomy. It's as if someone has placed a curse on it.
Ahem.
Oh, thought you might be a wolf.
Wolf? Ah!
There. Calm yourself, Hayward. It's only a human. Excuse me, Miss
Goldilocks.
Yes, Miss. Yes, Miss Goldilocks. It seems we have lost our way. We are heading to the market. And we must have taken a wrong turn. Do you know the area well?
I know it very well. To find the market, you must head toward the village. Simply follow this path, keeping the sign on your left shoulder. When you come to a fork in the path, take a left. That should lead you directly to the village.
Thank you. You have been a great help.
What was that? I don't know, but it ain't Mother Goose. Love to stay and chat, but we've got enough to worry about.
Will go nicely with these tender young children. The best stew ever.
A boy and a girl to make her stew. Oh my! A boy and a girl in Elder Creek.
Who or what was that?
The witches from the candy house. I heard the tales, but I thought they were only children's stories. Who are you?
Jack Horner, from the village, or I was. Seems I can't please anybody these days.
What brings you to the woods?
I was running from, well, a lot of things.
Well, welcome to the woods.
What about you? Do you have a name?
Why, yes, Goldilocks. Pretty silly, huh?
Not at all, it's different. Are you out here all by yourself?
I've been out here for years. Done a lot of running myself.
Kind of spooky out there.
Yes, but it wasn't always. Must be the old witch brought with her.
Did you say something about a stew? I'm starved.
Yes, but not the kind you'd enjoy. She said, "A boy and a girl to make my stew."
Ah, disgusting.
Hansel and Gretel? Oh, poor Woodsman. I bet that old witch caught his children.
Woodsman?
How would you like all the cakes, candies, and cookies you can eat?
Sounds great.
Come on, we don't have much time. I'll explain along the way.
Ugh, those mice were scary. Ugh, they were scary, and those mice, ick.
That was a close call.
We were lucky. This time, we've got to get out of these woods.
I was sure I let the boat tied up near the lake where we came in.
Indeed, I remember that as well.
We must get back to the village before nightfall.
It will be too dangerous in the Grimm's Wood at night.
I need to rest.
I'm so hungry.
Don't mention food. I'm famished. I'm dreaming of a beautiful ham and cheese sandwich.
Oh, yes, with mustards and piles of lovely ham.
Ham?
You see?
Nice work, Hayward. Finding that boat was real lucky. That wolf is miles behind us.
Gee, thanks, Stickley.
I have to admit, Hayward, that was a very good find.
Yep, we're home free. Not a care in the world. Just three little pigs out walking in the...
Here, piggy.
Nice piggies.
Something tells me we're not out of the woods yet.
Run!
Okay, what did I tell you? Things are getting crazy around here. Chases, wolves, witches. I hope things settle down soon. I'm getting worried about Hansel and Gretel. If only they knew that help was on the way. Will it get to them soon enough? We'll soon find out.
I can hear the witch, Gretel. She's coming for us. She's grown impatient waiting for me to fatten up. We'll never get out of here, sister. She'll eat us for sure.
Try to have faith, Hansel.
I know it seems hopeless, but I'll take care of you. I always do. Do you remember the night when Father left us here in the woods? And how bitterly cold it was?
I don't think I shall ever forget that night.
It seemed as though we would freeze to death. But then the full moon revealed the small opening in the hillside that protected us from the wind.
I remember, and I would trade anything to be back in that small cave in the woods. No food at all. Better than being for food for that horrible witch.
Calm yourself, brother. A plan will come. I won't let anything happen to you.
Stirring the old black kettle, I have newt and stinging nettle, dragon's blood and boiling water, next the woodsman's son and daughter.
Show me your finger, boy. Are we fattening you up nicely?
What's this? I feed you puddings and pies and potatoes and porridge, yet you're just as thin as the day I caught you eating my gingerbread roux. Why are you no fatter than a twig? Give me your finger again, boy. Thought you could fool an old blind woman, eh? Never mind. I've had many repulsive breaths in my day. And now's the time, my boy. Now is the time.
Gretel, make her stop. Make her stop.
Stop it. Stop it at once!
Save me, sister. Save me. What can you foolish sister do? Save yourself, little coward. perhaps with another one of your clever plans, like the breadcrumbs you saved and scattered to make a trail that would guide you back home.
My ravens made a quick meal of those. Brilliant.
Stop it! Stop it, you awful, awful old witch! Isn't it enough that you plan to eat us? Why must you frighten Hansel? He's only a little boy.
Just a little boy, you say? A greedy little boy. He practically destroyed my gingerbread roof.
He ate my prize sugar daffodils that took me years to perfect. Now I shall have to repaint my chocolate door. Poor little boy, indeed. He deserves to be eaten.
But we were starving! How could we have known that anyone would live in such an enchanted house?
We are enchanted by the lovely web the spider spins, but a wise bug keeps its distance. Oh, and fear not, my dear, you will not have to miss your brother for long when he is gone, for I have decided to have you for dessert.
Ah, need salt. Now then, don't go anywhere, my delectable little morsels. We'll be back for you soon. Mice, keep an ear out for these crafty little children. They mustn't escape.
Gretel, we must get out of here. There is no more time.
Hold on. I think I can read the keys.
I'm sorry, Hansel. I have let you down. The witches are too powerful and cunning. I see no way for our escape. It's all right, Gretel. It's not your fault. You've done everything a sister can do. You've been a father and a mother to me. I would never have made it this far without you. You're the best sister I could hope for.
Look, Jack, remember the woodsman I was telling you about? It's his kids.
But why are you locked in chain?
I don't know who you are or where you came from, but we're about to be dinner for the evil witches. Please, you must help us.
Of course.
Quickly.
What can we do?
Quickly, can you reach those keys?
Mice.
Guys.
Go get the gingerbread cookie. Go get it. Over there. Got it! Uh-oh.
You've got that right. Hide!
Ouch.
Ugh, this isn't salt, it's camel wart. Oh, great. No need to hurry right through my little lamb chops. I'll be right back. I must be getting hungry. For a moment, I thought that there was a whole room of children.
She's gone! Hurry!
Jack, the keys! Which one is it?
I think it's this one.
Okay.
Here you go. Now for Hansel.
Okay. It's not working.
Here, let me try. Got it.
We need a plan. They'll be back any moment.
The old witch thought there was a room full of children. Let's give her one.
Ka-ka! Where are we going to get any more children? And why would you need to bring them here? Well, that was quick.
No time for introductions. Just know that they are here to help.
Oh, no.
I know you, Odell. Come. come and join us for dinner, trespassers.
It is I, Gretel.
What's this?
And I, Hansel.
But that cannot be. You all locked? Over here!
Don't be a coy with me, you fool. In every game, there are certain rules in which layer you choose to train. I'll grind your bones to make my bread.
Over here.
And over here.
And over here.
You rotten children, you are everywhere. You have found some new magic.
We are here.
And here. And here.
I cursed you all.
My save us!
I say we get out of here before it really starts to smell.
I'm with you on that one.
Us too. Heist, wanna join us?
No, we'll stay here for shelter. Now that we're no longer under the roof, no.
Well?
Thank you for saving us too. Gum drop anyone?
Thanks! Let's go!
Walk out?
Wow, that was a close one. Looks like things might be working out for Hansel and Gretel after all. Let's check in on the others and see what's happening in the rest of the woods.
Finally a chance to sit and give my poor old feet a rest.
You there.
Drat, now what?
You there, excuse me?
What excuse is there for interrupting our rest? Oh, hum, yes?
I'm looking for someone. Have you seen the butcher?
No, but he could have made his way back to the village by now.
I suppose.
Let us walk you back.
Well, I am getting rather tired, and I've wandered all night, and if it's no trouble...
Not at all. Not at all, not at all. Say, that's a lovely shawl you're wearing.
Why, thank you.
You wouldn't be in the market for a magical cow in exchange, would you?
A magical cow?
Yes, yes, it only produces the finest chocolate milk.
Ooh, that sounds marvelous.
And you would be the only one to own such cow.
I would have the only one? Tell me more.
Here, Bessie. Here, little moo cow.
And the next thing I know, I'm stuck. It was terrible, just terrible.
Well, there's no need to trouble yourself about those mischievous little pigs. I'm sure they're far away from here and won't give you any more trouble. They're there.
Thank you kindly, Mildred.
Call me Grandma. Everyone does.
Gee, thanks. I've never had a grandma before.
I would never believe it if I had been by your side. just being ridiculous. Talking pigs.
Just a little further, my brothers. It says here, Unique needs a little roof work and a little paint. Candy exterior with large cooking area. Mouse landlord's perfect for keeping guests.
Sweet, sounds like home to me.
Home, wee wee wee, I wanna go home.
Well, forget straw, sticks and bricks. Candy it is. Let's go, Hayward.
I'm right there. I have to tell you, Goldilocks, I didn't think we would ever get out of the witch's lair. We are so lucky you all showed up.
That, dear brother, was nothing short of a miracle. But how did you guys know to look for us?
Well, there's still more to the story.
Yeah, I guess we should tell him, huh?
Tell us what?
I met a gentleman who's looking for you.
Someone's looking for us?
Yes, your father.
Father?
You've seen our father?
I have, yes. He asked me to meet you in the village if I found you.
Gretel, it's Father. Father, can you believe it?
Yes. I suppose it's rather unbelievable. The man who abandoned us in the woods. Strangely, I have dreamed of this day, of seeing Father again. But now that it's here, I'm not sure how to feel. After all, it was the one who left us here in the woods.
But he thought he'd left you to survive in the woods. Your stepmother convinced him that with so little food in the house, you would starve.
It's true. He thought that the only chance that you'd have to fend for yourself was near Elder Creek.
He told you this?
He told me of your stepmother's plot to rid the house of you and the food she had hidden away.
Father was so consumed by her beauty, she will drive him to an early grave.
I am afraid that she has preceded him to the grave. She died ill and alone.
Alone? Where was Father?
He was out looking for you.
Yes, after leaving you in the woods, he had realized what a horrible mistake he had made. He said he would understand if you never wanted to see him again, but he told me to tell you that he loves you.
He sounds like a great man.
I believe he has a good heart.
Well, then, I suppose there is only one thing left to be done. How would you feel about seeing Father again, Hansel?
I miss him, Gretel.
As do I, little brother. How will we find him?
He's taking a job now. He'll never go hungry again.
You can find him at Old Man Jessler's store.
In the village.
I live in the village, or I did. I can certainly take you there.
We also know the village. We can take you there, too.
You've already saved our lives.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you! Well, Hansel, I believe we better go home.
Let's go.
Thanks for all your help, Jack.
Thank you, Goldilocks. You're the first person I haven't run away from in a long time. If you're ever in the village, just let me know. I'll show you around. I know an old woman. She lives in a shoe. She's got so many kids, she doesn't even know what to do. So if you ever need work, I bet she could use a good babysitter.
Well, if you ever need a friend, you can count on me.
That's certainly better than counting magic beans.
I'll say. You'd better get to Hansel and Gretel back.
I will. Goodbye and good luck.
Can you imagine that? It's been quite an adventure these past couple of days, and as I said, just when you think things are the worst they can be, all bears, wolves, and witches, good things begin to happen. Well, the shadows are growing deeper, and my friend should be coming along any moment. I'm glad you could take the time to listen. Perhaps if you're on a walk in the woods someday, we could show you around.
But you better bring a lunch.
And some shoes.
Hello, fair damsels.
Hello.
You'll love the blackberry tart. Just baked this morning.
Yummy. And I talked Henny Penny out of a few fresh eggs.
That sounds terrific. You look great.
Well, having this kind woodsman to escort me on my trek has made all the difference.
My pleasure. It was the least I could do for my friends for bringing Hansel and Gretel back.
Well, seems we've all had a happy ending. I'd better go to Grandma's. She's going to teach us a new stitch tonight.
And we brought treats for the wolf.
He's going to show us a new trick.
Tell her and her wolf hello and have a safe trip.
And remember, no matter the hardships, love is what truly matters. Good night.
Good night. Ah, yes, love.
And as for you, thanks for bringing the magic to my woods, and keep an eye out for wolves on your way home.
I don't have to yell. Bob took care of all of our lights and sound for Children's Dinner Theater, and we appreciate him so much. So we have a little something for you, Bob, whenever you can come get it. And Terry Burgett, are you here, Terry? So yes, she does not have any kids in the play this time, but she still came and coordinated costumes for us, which was a huge help. It's a big deal. So thank you, Terry. And Stephanie Kirk, come on, Bob. Abby's got it for you. You can go get him. Is Stephanie Kirk in here? It's hard to see. Is she? Okay. She's probably doing the dinner. Hey, Stephanie. So Stephanie coordinated the dinner for us. Woo! It was delicious. There you go, Stephanie. You're welcome. And Abby Lauer, who is our stage manager. I think they like you, Abby.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Sam Leahy, who is the assistant stage manager. Yes. Deani Galligan, who got our cherubs ready, which was so great. She also did a lot of the makeup, too. So come on up. There you go. You're welcome. And then for our assistant director, Linda, come on up. There you go. Thank you so much. Linda and then also Sharon have spent so much time and energy with these kids this week. To give She and Linda a little walk in the woods on their own.
Oh,
so
yes.
Thank you for all that you guys do. Thank you so much.